today on Florida Sport Fishing.
Probably, arguably, the most effective bottom fishing rig of all time.
Here we go again.
Whoa, hey, baby.
Nice, dude. Good fish, good fish.
A fatty, baby.
They eat everything.
Awesome fish.
That thing is beautiful.
Ho ho, what on?
CV Boats presents Florida Sport Fishing, television for the avid angler, powered by Mercury Marine.
Oh, yeah.
Got one on.
Oh.
There's a sailfish, already got a bite.
Ridiculous.
Another one on.
That's what it's all about right there.
Nice jump.
Oh, look at that.
Florida Sport Fishing TV proudly endorses and utilizes Ghost, the global leader in boat security, monitoring, tracking, and surveillance. Frigid Rigid, from 35 to 300 quarts, the finest coolers and freezers on the water. VMC Hooks, tired of missed strikes? Fish the hooks the pros fish. Fish VMC. Motor Guide, the most dependable trolling motors on the water. BioGreen Clean, the first and only eco-friendly, heavy-duty multi-surface cleaner that actually works.
Hey guys, you ready to get hooked up? I'm Captain Mike and you're watching Florida Sport Fishing TV. We're aboard our CV370Z today and we've got a really cool episode in store. We're going to start off the day doing some wreck fishing. We're going to fish a variety of different spots ranging in depths from around 125 foot all the way on up to almost 300 foot, all the way up and down the southeast coast here. And we're going to highlight just a couple of really effective techniques, one of them being the high-low rig. This has been a staple in the sport fishing and the party boat industry for years, for decades really, and I'll tell you what, extremely effective. We're also going to do some jigging, some vertical jigging throughout the day, and you know what, we'll see what happens. Who knows where we may end up. So stick around, let's see if we get hooked up. The idea is to keep that rig right on the bottom, you know, that's the ticket with that high-low. You've got one hook, 12 to 18 inches off the bottom, and you've got another one 3 or 4 feet off the bottom. And you just want to drift around reefs and wrecks, you know, any sort of structure, that's going to be the key. I also like to try, you know, different spots and different depths, you know, on some days those deeper spots, 250, 275, you know, they're going to produce. On other days, you may have to fish that 125 to 150 foot range. So don't be afraid to experiment, try different depths until you get dialed in. Don't just sit in one spot all day long. Something. Oh, a little porgy.
Yep, porgy.
Yep, nice little porgy.
Nice size.
Again, high-low rig, and there it is right there.
Beautiful.
These fish right here, these porgies, don't get the credit that they deserve. You know, they're certainly not one of the most glamorous fish, but they're absolutely great on the dinner table. There's a variety of different types of porgies and different fish in the porgy family.
Good eating.
Really pretty, oh, really, really good eating. You know, like we said earlier, if you want to put some dinner on the table, that high-low rig is the way to go. Nice about these porgies too, they're schooling fish. So often when you catch one, you'll catch a few more as well. And this fish was way off the wreck. So don't be afraid to drift off the meat of the structure because sometimes that's where they'll be hanging out.
Fortress, the world's best anchors. Stronger, faster, lighter. High-tech aluminum alloy makes Fortress anchors the easiest to handle. Precision machining and sharpening results in the fastest setting anchor. Fortress buries deep for the strongest holding power. With 8 models from 4 to 69 pounds, there's a Fortress anchor for you. Fortress, stronger, faster, lighter.
It's your turn to score big. Book a long-range adventure aboard the legendary Yankee Captains. Fish virgin waters more than 100 miles offshore for exotic queen snapper, trophy tilefish, monster grouper, and more. With a lifetime of experience, let Captain Greg Mercurio and his dedicated crew put you on a hot bite. fish around the clock or just relax. With full galley and huge fish boxes, all you'll need to bring is your appetite for action. Now sailing from Key West year-round.
The Bubba Blade makes filleting fish faster, easier, and safer. Check this out. The Bubba Blade is super sharp and has a super grip.
You can feel everything with this knife. It's really nice.
The Bubba Blade is the only fillet knife you're ever going to need. So check out our website, bubbablade.com, and order your Bubba Blade today.
What if navigating was as simple as touch and go? It is that simple. The world's first multi-touch MFT chart plotter, Navnet TZ Touch.
You know, the high-low rig, extremely effective. Been a staple in the party boat industry for decades. Sport fishermen, recreational fishermen. You know, it's just a great application, a great technique for a variety of different venues when you're reef and wreck fishing. It's very simple, but very effective. The variety is really what it's all about. One drop, you may catch a short little snapper or grouper, who knows. And on the next drop, it may be, you know, a cobia or an African pompano. It's a great tactic for kids, for novice anglers, for, you know, when the bite's slow up on the edge or kite fishing, you want to put some meat in the boat and some dinner on the table, tie on a high-low rig, get out to some structure, squid, chunk baits, that's all you need to have an absolutely great time. That's a good one, dude. Yeah, yeah. Look how pretty that thing is. Nice job.
They eat everything. The last one I got on a goggle eye head. This one ate some squid. Anything that's got some smell and some taste to it, they're all over it. Squid, ballyhoo, goggle eyes. Look at that, you can see their extended tentacle on my arm. If you look at my arm, that's the rest of the fin. That's so beautiful.
That's gotta be one of the coolest looking fish right there.
2 feet back, look at that. And that's like translucent. See how it goes from white to black? That's still part of the fin.
Fat little vermilion.
That's an 11 and a halfer. Look at that.
That's like the one I let go. Look at the hook. It's not even in his mouth, dude.
That's happened more than once. You know
He's
that, right?
He's holding on to the bait.
He's holding on to the squid. Oh, man.
Service and repair. Presented by Pelagic Gear, official apparel provider of Florida Sport Fishing TV.
Hey guys, I'm Captain Mike. I'm here with Ed Federkyle at California Custom Sport Trucks. You guys know Cal Customs right here in Fort Lauderdale. This is the place to go. These guys are gonna convert your ordinary stock tow vehicle into the vehicle that you've wanted all along. Suspension systems, tires, rims, LED lights, audio and security systems, the whole range of accessories. And Ed, lately you guys have a new solution to stop the squat. And you guys know exactly what I mean. You hook your boat up, your trailer to your tow vehicle, the back bottoms out, the front unloads, creates a really unsafe driving condition. It's also really inefficient. Ed, tell us a little bit more about this Roadmaster active suspension system and how it works.
The age-old problem of properly managing towing has changed quite drastically with the advent of this particular product. All leaf spring equipped vehicles, whether it be a van, a pickup, SUV, can benefit from this when not only towing their boat, but towing their utility trailer, work trailer, car trailer, any type of trailer. What this thing does is it helps you manage your factory towing capacity. Your leaf spring typically has an arch to it. When you load it, it wants to flatten out. What the Roadmaster does is it'll help restore that arc when loaded. When you're not towing, it's a very passive system where you don't even really know it's there. But once you load a trailer on, it springs into action and actually helps the spring get to its natural position, stops the squat and helps you tow more safely.
Perfect. And Ed, is this something that has to be professionally installed, or somebody who's mechanically inclined, can they do it on their own?
Someone that has a good set of mechanics tools and has some mechanical ability, we can ship this to you and you can do it at your own leisure in your driveway.
Gotcha, perfect. And also perfect for stock vehicles. I mean, does it affect a warranty, anyone's warranty at all?
No, it does not affect the factory warranty and will actually enhance the handling even when you're not towing.
Perfect. And how does somebody get their hands on a Roadmaster active suspension system?
You can call us up at 1-800-449-8469. Shoot us an email, we'll send you one out and you'll be towing right before you know it.
You know, whenever you're reef or wreck fishing, you're fishing a lot of dead bait, chunk baits. One thing that's absolutely essential and really, really helpful is a rod holder mount fillet table, like this one from Boat Outfitters. This one is just really nice. It's adjustable, so of course you can really fit it into any angle rod holder. It's got a little beverage holder, little place for a rag and some rigs, and of course your bubble blade can fit right there. Just a perfect setup for any boat and an absolute must-have for bottom fishermen around the whole state of Florida.
Mercury engine test.
Fuel efficiency you can rely on. It's good to have Mercury behind you.
When you want to get away from it all, to a place where you can do everything or nothing at all, surrounded by natural beauty and all the modern amenities you might desire, then you'll want to be here at the Wannabe Inn on the beautiful shores of Manasota Key, Florida. To plan your escape, log on to wannabein.com.
Joey Accardi Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram reminds you that before you can do this, you have to do this. And before you can do that, you're going to need this. Save thousands on every new Ram truck at Joey Accardi in Pompano Beach. Family owned and operated and bringing South Florida our best deals for over 25 years. So before you can do this, do this. And before you can do this, you have to do this. Visit JoeyAccardiCDJR.com.
Another one on the jig.
That's grouper dynamo.
Yeah! How's that for a sea monster?
Chaos. Gear matters. Shop online or visit our new superstore for everything fishing.
Mercury engine test.
Speed and acceleration you can rely on. It's good to have Mercury behind you.
Doing a combination of a couple different things here. We're jigging, as we mentioned earlier, doing some vertical jigging, and also fishing some bait with these high lows. Sometimes they want the meat, sometimes they want the metal. We'll give them both.
Porgy?
Another porgy.
That one's a little fatter there. Yeah.
Oh yeah.
Nice.
Oh yeah. Love it. Look at the colors on this one too. And those teeth. I mean, that thing right there is designed for crushing crabs and shellfish. You don't want to put your finger right in there. Look at those crunchers. They almost look like little pebbles.
They got mouth like
right
sheep's
there?
Head.
Yeah, dude. Well, it's definitely related to the sheep's head.
It's a deep water sheep's head, pretty much.
VMC 5-0 octopus hook. This is a different species of porgy than the one that you had just caught there. You know, there's a wide variety of them. Not sure if this is a jolt head or not, but whatever it is.
It's a nice fish for dinner.
Yeah, nice fish for dinner, nice fish on the high-low. We'll get him on ice and catch another one. What I like to do when I'm fishing the bottom with these high-low rigs is, of course, I drop all the way to the bottom, use enough lead to obviously keep that rig in the strike zone right on the bottom, but not too much lead, you know, but you definitely want that vertical presentation, and that's gonna be based on the depth of the water, the current. Right now, 10 and 12 ounces seems to be the ticket in these 250 to 280 foot spots. And I keep my reel and free spool. I keep my finger on the spool as we're drifting along. I'm constantly just paying out a couple feet at a time just to make sure that that rig stays right on the bottom. I don't want it to come off the bottom. Get a bite, lock it up, drive the hook home, and boom, you're good to go. I don't even dare to guess what this is. He's got some shoulders, whatever it is. Nice African pompano.
That a boy?
Yep.
Nice. I had
African
a feeling.
Pompano.
This is the time of year to get them here, man. That's awesome.
Nice fish. Nice fish. Look at them just all flared out like that.
As soon as you got down there, huh?
Yeah. Not huge, but.
That's a beautiful fish, man.
Yep.
So cool.
Look at that. Really awesome. Look at those little trailers like that. Somewhat resembles kind of a rooster fish, but. And these are wreck dwellers, reef dwellers. And they'll get big. I've seen them up to 50, 60 pounds. This guy, of course, is a little juvenile. They do get much larger. It's a good eating fish.
Very good.
Very sporty fighter. Aggressive. But just beautiful. I mean, look at those top flares like that. Look at that. It's just awesome. Just another species. I mean, snappers, porgies, African pompano. Everything eats those high lows. Everything. One thing that's important to remember, whenever you're wreck fishing, even though you're, you know, off the beach here on the southeast coast, you can see we're obviously not very far off the beach and we're already in 250 feet of water. Of course, on the Gulf, you're gonna be way offshore. But the tide also plays a role in wreck fishing. It really does. A lot of guys don't realize that. You know, sometimes that incoming tide or an outgoing tide will really influence where those fish are laying in relation to the structure below. And there's certainly going to be occasions where they'll only bite on one or the other tide. Sometimes they won't bite on other tide. And of course, sometimes they'll bite on both tides. But pay attention to what that tide is doing in relation to where your boat is, where your rigs are. And I'll tell you what, over time, you'll certainly be able to develop a pattern.
Rigging Station, presented by Diamond Fishing Products, the finest monofilament, fluorocarbon, and braided fishing line in the world.
Hi, welcome to this episode's Rigging Station. If you're just joining us, we're out here doing some wreck fishing, just really highlighting the high-low rig. We've talked about this a lot today. We touched on the wrecks, we touched on positioning, currents, bait, the variety of species that you can catch. And what I want to do now is just talk to you about the rig itself and exactly how it's tied. So you can see right on the bottom, I just have a small little dropper loop. This is what's going to hold my bank sinker. You do not want to use a pyramid sinker or an egg sinker. For this application, it's all about the bank sinker. We're fishing anywhere from 8, 10, 12, even 16 ounces, depending on the depth and depending on the current. About 18 inches up from the sinker is a small little dropper loop that I've tied right into the leader right there with a 5-0 VMC octopus circle hook. And again, about 3 feet up above that is another dropper loop with another hook, same identical thing. And again, this is the high and this is the low. And as this rig sits right on the bottom, you can see that the baits are suspended up off the bottom. The rig is tied on 50-pound diamond presentation fluorocarbon. The leader's gotta be fairly heavy. You're fishing really tight to the structure. While it may be a little bit overkill for the little vermilions, you hook a good quality fish, a big snapper, a porgy, who knows what else, you're gonna want that extra abrasion resistance. I'm fishing this on a variety of different rods today, 7 and 8 foot rods rated for 12 to 20 pound on the smaller side and 15 to 30 pound on the larger side. We're fishing the Daiwa Saltiga Hyperspeed reels loaded with 20 and 30 pound diamond braid with a little bit of a top shot, 40 and 50 pound fluorocarbon top shot about 25 foot long. It's really that simple. Anybody can tie this. You certainly can purchase high-low rigs at your local tackle shop or boating accessory store, but they're so simple to tie and they're deadly effective. You'll notice here on this Furuno TZ Touch, I've got the bottom zoomed up on the left side of my monitor here, on the left side of my display, just to get a little bit of a better picture as to what's happening down there. And really what you're looking at here is this is the actual wreck right here on the bottom. A little bit of relief, which is part of the wreck that's coming up off the top. And I don't see too much around it right now. You know, all of these readings would appear to be fish. This is actually all part of that structure. You can clearly see from those vertical lines, that's all part of that structure right now. Just a little piece of that wreck sticking off the side.
Florida Sport Fishing is the number one magazine for the latest tips, tricks, tactics, and techniques. Close to 200 pages, each issue is packed with instructional articles, easy-to-follow illustrations, and award-winning photography. Only $29.97 for a two-year subscription. For home delivery, visit fsftv.com. Subscribe now and receive a free shirt, unlimited access to our new digital edition, and a special bonus gift.
The award-winning Z Performance line from CV raises the bar. It's not just fast. It's not just fuel efficient. The CVZ is the entire package. It offers the perfect balance, safe, predictable handling during hard turns and at high speed. And most importantly, the Z stays on plane at lower speed so it can comfortably handle anything Mother Nature can dish out. Experience the exhilarating ride of the CVZ. Schedule a sea trial today.
Introducing the newest kick-ass knife from Bubba Blade, the 9-inch serrated flex. Check this out. The Bubba Blade 9-inch serrated fillet knife's razor-sharp tip allows you to easily pierce tough scales or skin.
Look at that. Right through the scales. Look at that. Beautiful. Right along the bone.
This is one knife every fisherman is going to want to have.
Beautiful.
Go to BubbaBlade.com or call us to order your new 9-inch serrated flex today.
Florida Sport Fishing TV proudly endorses and utilizes Boat Outfitters, a huge selection of tackle storage systems to keep your gear organized and your lines tight. Salt Life Sport Optics. Ask for them by name and see what you've been missing. Dr. Dan's, from lip balm to sunblock, a complete skincare line designed for life on the water. Tropic Trailer, Florida's largest dealer, has the right trailer at the right price. Rugged Shark, technical footwear designed for boating and fishing enthusiasts.
A nice yellowtail.
Yeah.
A nice yellowtail.
Again, the high-low scores!
Yellowtail, look at that!
That's a nice one, couple pounds.
Yet another species on the high-low.
Check this one out, beautiful fish. Nice snapper.
Are you in me? Is this boat not big enough for the both of us?
Got my own fish. You keep
three
your fish over there.
Three of us on a 37-foot boat.
Keep your fish over there. This is my sandwich. Nice porgy. Yep.
Nice porgy.
Nice porgy.
Woo!
Beautiful.
That's a jolt head. Come on, baby. Oh, yeah. A fatty, baby. High-low, baby, does it again all day long. If that's not a fish right there that's designed for eating shellfish, crabs, lobsters, those little bottom teeth and the top crushers, so much pressure in that mouth could literally just crush a clam open. Not a very glamorous fish, but they really deserve a lot more credit than they receive. They're colorful, really pretty, great on the dinner table, and a lot of fun to catch on the high-low rigs. Woo, smoking you right back into the wreck. Oh, there's one too. Whatever you got, I got one too. Uh-oh, right. Gotta get him up out of the wreck. Ah, mine came off.
Feels like a nice
mutton. Yeah, it could be a mutton the way they were hitting.
The way he hit it, the way he was swimming, the way he is fighting.
Yeah, well, we shall see. Staying fairly straight up and down. I'll tell you what, guys, if you're just joining us, we're out here doing a little bit of wreck fishing, caught a variety of species, highlighting the high-low rig, you know, just an absolute staple. And we're tight again. Easy, easy on that lift. There he is,
right up on top.
Not sure what it is. It's a
Jack?
Big
porgy.
A mutton.
Snapper?
Mutton.
No. Snapper.
Dude, it's a mutton.
Porgy, dude. That's
a porgy or a mutton?
That is a huge porgy. That's what that is.
Nice
porgy. Look at the size of that porgy.
Nice porgy.
Yes,
woo!
Nice porgy. That's a sweetie.
Nice.
That's a Margate.
That is a Margate. That's exactly a Margate. What that is, dude. Cousin to the porgy.
Dude, that's a Florida record Margate.
Awesome fish.
That thing is beautiful.
Awesome. Look at that.
That is pretty.
Beautiful. Look at that blunt little nose that he's got right there. See it? This is just a perfect example. Do one drop, you catch a 1 pound vermilion.
Next drop.
Next drop, you catch an absolutely beautiful margate. Really just a super, super eating fish on a dinner table. Clearly a hard fighting fish.
Oh yeah.
Look at that orange mouth that this guy's got.
See how they feed with that. Nice.
He's fat, dude. He's got some weight to him. I mean, that's a good fish right there in the Tortugas. That's a good fish down, you know, off Key West on a wreck somewhere. And for right here off the southeast coast.
It's a beautiful fish.
That's a beauty. You guys have a good time today fishing the high lows?
Awesome, man.
It's amazing.
Right? Absolutely awesome, guys. We had a great day just fishing a whole bunch of different spots, catching a variety of different fish. You know, we talked a lot about the tackle. We talked a lot about the rigs, about the wrecks, you know, fishing the tide. And of course, then there's seasons. You know, right now, still technically winter time. It's a great time to bottom fish in Florida during the winter. Now, of course, the winter months overall produce the best fishing, you know, for everything as far as I'm concerned. Wahoo fishing, sail fishing. We've had an excellent season, dolphin fishing throughout the entire year. Catch big swords in the winter. And plenty of fish on the bottom. We're gonna go ahead and get this fish up. Probably wrap it up here today. Hopefully you picked up a whole bunch of tips and tricks. Make sure to check out our YouTube channel. Check out Florida Sport Fishing on Facebook. Follow us on Instagram. And get hooked up with Florida Sport Fishing gear at shop.floridasportfishing. We'll see you next week.
To learn more about the tactics and techniques seen on today's show and to subscribe to Florida Sport Fishing Magazine, visit floridasportfishing.com and get hooked up.